Everybody, Erin Coscarelli here, and I am really excited to be with our brand new defensive coordinator for the Las Vegas Raiders, Gus Bradley. Gus, thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, it's my pleasure. My pleasure. Very excited about it as well.
I can get that sense from you because I had an opportunity to watch you during your press conference, and I got a sense from Raider Nation how excited they are to have you be a part of this team and what you've been able to do with the Chargers and, of course, with Seattle. And just your own resume speaks for itself. So for me, my first question for you, though, Gus, is what about being a part of the Raiders appealed to you?
Well, first of all, you know, I have a longstanding relationship with Coach Gruden. You know, we worked together. He hired me in 2006 at Tampa Bay. And then on that staff was Greg Olson and Rich Versace. I knew a lot about Rod Marinelli. I mean, multiple guys that are on the current staff. Tom Cable, I worked with at the Seattle Seahawks and developed a relationship with him. So first of all, it's the relationship with the coaches. But there's also, I mean, the Raiders now, that's iconic. And they go back so many years and they're so well thought of, and the fan base and Raider Nation and just everything about it. There's so much energy. And, you know, I think we all thrive on that part of it. So that's also so exciting. And then, you know, when I was in the interview, Mark Davis came in and he shared his vision along with John Gruden. And I could see that Mike, John, and Mark were all really tied together on where they wanted to take this organization. So, you know, it all just came and fit together perfectly.
It seems like a nice natural fit. And like you mentioned, you're getting an opportunity to reunite with Coach Gruden. I believe Tampa 2006, 2008, right before you went to Seattle, correct?
Correct.
So how exciting is it to be able to get back in and reunite with Coach Gruden?
Oh, it's great. You know, when I sat down in the meeting room, it was like we picked up right where we left off. And he's always been so good to me personally and our family. When I was the head coach at Jacksonville, my wife was very involved in a charity function and asked if he could come to speak. And he flew or came over from Tampa just to be a part of that. And, you know, he's there's just a special relationship we have. And I appreciate him so much. And just the chance to come back and help serve this organization and this team is great.
Well, and I sense from both of you guys, obviously, you're just passionate about football. And one of the things that you see from Coach Gruden, especially this past season, is his passion about coaching young guys. And what you will be taking over, and I'm sure obviously you're aware, is a younger roster. There's more young guys on this team than older, obviously. For you, Coach, where do you start when it comes to your defensive philosophy? And now that you're going to be taking over a lot of young guys on the team.
Well, I think that's what we're accustomed to. I think when we designed the system, multiple guys did it at Seattle. It was a system designed to have the opportunity for younger guys to play early. And guys like I mentioned before, like Earl Thomas and Richard Sherman, these guys had to play early in their career. Now, I guess what I've learned also my time in Jacksonville, well, you need a mix, right? You need that youth, but you also, the veteran presence is so important within a locker room and on a unit to help that message. So, and that's what I feel like this team, you know, it's got the youth, it's got some veteran presence, and we're going to rely on both of them. But I think the big thing is we're a developmental coaching staff, and it's our job to really help these players get to where they need to be and to help this organization, this fan base, provide a team that they're all excited about.
And I think that one of the biggest challenges, and Coach Gruden obviously has made mention of it, is the dealing with COVID, because having young guys trying to go through situational football obviously presents its own set of challenges because you're not allowed to be on the field even close to as much. So for you, I mean, where do you believe you need to start when it comes to the defense?
Well, you're right. It is hard, but I think I'm grateful for the opportunity to go through it already 1 year. You know, because now if it happened to be through Zoom, you kind of went through some of the kinks. You understand how to do it, the best way to teach, and the best way to utilize the Zoom and all those aspects. So, but it really becomes, you know, I think football, the game of football, especially defensively, is such a fundamental game. And I think the communication and the terms that we use, the trigger terms that help these guys play fast, that is so important. So we'll start there with that and then build the defense from that point on.
Well, one of the advantages that we have with you, Gus, is you know this division really, really well. It is not an easy division, of course. Obviously, you know you have to go through Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. For you, though, where do you feel like you need to when it comes to figuring out the AFC West? Do you believe that that is an advantage for you, that this is something that you know really well in terms of all the other offenses, and now obviously having the challenge of going against Justin Herbert?
Right. Well, you know, and each offense changes a little bit each year, right? But I think it is an advantage that you have a little bit of an understanding, unless they make coaches changes, you know, like they do with the Chargers. But I think overall, what I appreciate this is going against the Raider offense. I mean, we've gone through them, 3 years now. And to see, like I mentioned earlier, the progress that's being made. And it's an offense that can score points. And in this division, that is so important. And then it's our job is to keep those points down. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think that you're right. It is a very tough division, but it's an exciting division. You wouldn't want it any other way. Each game is exciting and demanding and intense. And, you know, we got to make sure we bring our game and then some.
Well, and I think from a fan's perspective, I speak for myself, I think it's very smart getting a gentleman who's very familiar with this division in somebody like you. And your defenses, as you've shown in the past, have been incredibly competitive. So we're very fortunate we have someone who's quite the expert in the AFC West like yourself. Now, you've mentioned Raider Nation. And Raider Nation, like you said offline, you were talking about how the fans are so devoted. And that is one thing you get when you come to the Raider side of things. They are intense and they love their team and they are devout. For you, you were talking about it offline. Why are you so excited to be a part of Raider Nation? And you've been in that stadium, that Allegiant Stadium. What did you think when you went in for the first time?
I think when we talked about earlier that I got a phone call from a former player. And they played in the stadium like 2 weeks or 3 weeks before we did and said, Gus, just wait till you drive up to that stadium. It's unbelievable. And just the atmosphere. And he said, driving in and coming into the environment and seeing it and how it fits in. He says, I can't explain to you. And when we pulled up on the bus and I saw it, I was like, holy cow, he was dead on now. And there were fans outside. But you got to understand, here it is for, you know, especially this year, to play in front of a stadium or a stadium where there's no fans. But I was just thinking to myself too this week was, you know, on third down, you know, in the stadium, how much of an advantage that is for a defense to have a fan base like we have and the support that they get. Now, you know, we got to come out and play aggressive style of defense and to get the fans going as well. But boy, when you can count on that there's going to be a great fan base in there for you, all those third down opportunities for that rush to get going is huge.
I love that you're already thinking about the advantage of fans on third down inside that Allegiant Stadium, because it's true. One thing that I've been hearing so much of, and one thing I cannot wait for next season, is to get fans inside Allegiant, because you're absolutely right. Pictures don't even do it justice when you get inside. It is such a sight to behold. So I'm really excited to have you be a part of the season next year and have fans inside the stadium. And one last question, because I know you're really busy, but we know you're a big football fan. We know you're passionate about football, obviously Coach Gruden as well. What does Gus Bradley like to do when you're not watching film and you're not coaching football? What do you like to do, Coach?
Well, you know what? Our family is very important to us, and we try to spend as much family time. But I love to fish, and, you know, that's when I'm down here now. I hadn't had a chance to see my son for a couple of weeks. He wasn't home for Christmas, so I came down here, and we're just going to spend a couple of days on the water and get to know each other, reconnect a little bit. But you know, I think their whole family's passionate. I'm looking forward to Vegas and what it has to offer. My brother just bought a place in St. George and was telling me about some of the area. You know, they fly into Vegas and, you know, so you hear so many good things about it. So we're looking forward to that. Although I don't know how much time I'll get a chance to see, you know, everything outside. It'll be mostly in the office and preparing. But, you know, I'm just really excited about the fan base and the coaching staff, the ownership, and everything that is coming our way. So I appreciate you having me.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for joining us today. We're really excited to have you be a part of this season. Enjoy fishing with your son, and welcome to Raider Nation.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thanks, Coach.
Okay.